We bring you developments in the Percy Lapid Slay case as authorities make headway in their investigation. Philippine Justice Secretary Boying Remulla says they hope to file cases by the end of the week, adding that the probe has been very satisfactory. The secretary also says it's very possible the mastermind in the killing of veteran broadcaster Percy Lapid has been identified. In related news, another person of interest in the killing of veteran broadcaster Percy Lapid set to give his statement to authorities. The fifth inmate is now in the custody of the National Bureau of Investigation. Justice Department spokesperson Mico Clavano declined to divulge the identity of the inmate. But he did confirm he is the same person identified by Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla as the eighth person of interest in the murder.
Last night, around midnight, there was a transfer from the intelligence service of the AFP detention facility. There's one inmate there who was transferred to the NBI custody as well. Around midnight, na transfer yon. So today, there will be an investigation and question and answer. Hopefully, we get his statement as well.
On Thursday, the PNP and the NBI interviewed four inmates who are persons of interest in Lapid's murder. Results of the independent autopsy on the body of alleged middleman Jun Villamor out Saturday. Dr. Raquel Fortun was initially set to release her findings Friday, but she asked for another day to finish her report.
I did hear that she wanted to come up with a thorough, at least 6 pages daw yung magiging report niya. So I think she just wants to be thorough. She understands the gravity of the report that she's creating or she's making. So I'm sure that Dr. Raquel Fortun is just being diligent no, in her work.
Justice Secretary Remulla earlier requested Fortun to conduct a second autopsy on the body of Villamor. The alleged middleman died inside the National Penitentiary on October 18th, hours after self-confessed gunman Joel Escorial was presented to the public. The first autopsy conducted by the NBI showed Villamor had a heart hemorrhage and that there were no signs of physical injuries on the body. Former Prisons Bureau Chief Rafael Ragos recants his allegations against former Senator Laila de Lima before a Muntinlupa court. Let's get more details from our correspondent Johnson Manaba. Johnson?
Hi, Denise. Good afternoon. Former Philippine Senator Laila de Lima attended another court hearing in Muntinlupa City this morning where she's facing illegal drug charges. De Lima did not grant any interview or make any statement after the hearing. Former Bureau of Corrections officer in charge, Rafael Ragos, testified again in Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court Branch 204, where he affirmed his testimony recanting his allegations against the former lawmaker. According to Ragos' counsel, attorney Michael De Castro, his client told the court who convinced him to pin De Lima on illegal drug trade in Bilibid. De Castro adds Ragos had three affidavits dated September 5, September 26, 2016, and March 2017. Ragos claimed in his affidavit that he was merely coerced by former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre II to implicate De Lima. Aguirre has denied the claim. De Castro said when Ragos made his testimony against De Lima, that time he doesn't have any lawyer, which according to him is a basic right under the Constitution. De Lima's lawyers had hoped Ragos's affirmation of his recantation would deal a big blow to the government's case against the detained senator. Ragos and De Lima are expected to be in court again on November 4 for the continuation of the hearing where Ragos will be cross-examined by the prosecution. Meanwhile, another lawyer of De Lima, attorney Filibon Bonita Cardon, said the court granted De Lima's request for a medical furlough. De Lima is expected to be in a hospital in Manila anytime today for a thorough medical checkup. Denise.
Thanks for that report, Johnson.